Prague Castle, the symbolic seat of power in the Czech Republic. Here sits President Václav Havel, his elite guard performing their daily ritual in the courtyard below. Soon there'll be a different changing of the guard here. President Havel has just weeks before he leaves office. But unlike the well-oiled machinery of his troops, politics in the Czech Republic do not run smoothly, and the president will leave behind a country in political disarray.
Up to 70% of all Czechs think that democratic parties are not doing their job right, and that politics is a corrupt business.
Corruption, scandal, and dubious tactics at the polls. Czech voters are fed up. Czechs have certainly felt the sunny side of the street in the last decade or so. They were quick to throw off the shackles of communism with a healthy appetite for wealth and freedom. Those dark days are now a dim memory. For some, there's no memory at all. In a busy backstreet pub, a group of young Czechs blends in, four of the 40 members of the budding young communist party.
Pak je skupina lidí, kteří nám drží palce, a samozřejmě těch pár lidí je takových zřivých antikomunistů, že jo, nedemokratů, kteří by nás třeba rovnou vyšli na lucerny a podobně.
26-year-old computer network manager Zdenek Stefek is party leader. Just 13 when the communists were ousted, he has rediscovered old ideals.
Protože v podstatě naprostá většina hnutí, kteří se, nebo hnutí a stran, které se dostaly na špici do politik, tak zklamala, protože něco jiného slibovali a skutečnost potom vypadala jinak. Takže to je jedna věc, čili je to zásadová, jednoznačná politika komunistické strany.
Communism, enforced by the might of the Soviet Union. It inflicted decades of oppression on the Czech people. Hundreds of thousands were killed, jailed, or sent to labor camps. Finally, the people rose up as one. Six weeks in late 1989 became known worldwide as the Velvet Revolution, the bloodless coup that toppled the regime. So the communists were defeated, democracy restored, and the people of the Czech Republic have since enjoyed their freedom. But it hasn't been a fairy tale ending to the story at Prague Castle. Instead, the political parties of the new democracy have descended into a quagmire of squabbling as they fight to steer the country in different directions. In the meantime, the unthinkable has happened. The Communist Party has quietly enjoyed a resurgence. The warning bells sounded at the mid-year elections. Hundreds of thousands of Czechs stayed away from the polling booths. Those who did vote gave one party a massive swing of 200,000 extra votes and 40 seats in parliament. The Communist Party.
The Communist Party is now seen by many young people as a clean party. it is slightly absurd, but this is a party that, because it has not been in any government in the last 13 years, could not have gotten its hands dirty, so to speak.
Former political advisor to President Václav Havel, Jiří Pehe, says the main political parties have themselves to blame.
The Communist Party has become a protest party. A lot of people, many people who wanted to punish the democratic parties for what they have seen as corruption, as lack of principles.
No one knows more about the mudslinging than Hanna Marvanova. This is the first time in 13 years the former student dissident has returned to Ruzynia prison, where she was jailed by the communists. These days, she's the country's most senior female politician.
Já to považuji za nesmírně důležitou zkušenost ve svém životě, protože kdo nezažil takovouto extrémní zkušenost, tak neví přesně, co to obnáší.
Back in her old cell, she shudders at the memories, unable to believe the Communist Party might be on the comeback trail.
A já se domnívám, že ať fašistické nebo komunistické strany, pokud dostanou prostor a příležitost vládnou, tak mají vždycky tendenci nastolit totalitní režim, který končí stejně u lidských obětí, proto není možné jim dát znovu příležitost.
A parliamentary deputy and former party leader. It wasn't Hanna Marvanova's politics that hit the headlines, but her sex life. Pornographic magazine Hustler targeted the single mother of two in an article called The Love Life of Our Joan of Arc. Subtitled The Great Bed Tandem, it delivered a sordid barrage of accusations that she'd deliberately seduced married men, used sex for favours from journalists, and generally bedhopped. It questioned the paternity of her children and flouted the suicide of her father. In short, it was devastating. Not that Hustler's Czech editor, Martin Danish, is remotely apologetic.
Já budu opakovat to, co už jsem řekl. Já ten článek jsem považoval za velmi kvalitní. Vím, že byl taky velmi pečlivě vyrešeršovaný oběma autory, že to nebylo něco, co by napsali z voleje za jeden nebo za dva dny. Takže s tím článkem, jak jsem řekl, jsem byl spokojen. Považoval jsem ho jeden z nejlepších, které jsme v Asteru zatím měli.
Hanna Marvanova denies every accusation.
Tak já jsem byla maximálně znechucená z toho. A jestli mám říct, že mě to trápilo, tak mě to trápí do dneška, ale na druhou stranu já se snažím tím příliš nezabývat a dělat, jako kdyby to nebylo, nezabývat se ani tím obsahem, ani jsem to doma neřešila, nebo s dětmi.
I am almost sure that this was a political scheme that someone felt that shortly before the election a politician who could be potentially popular could take votes away from other parties from the competitors that this was the kind of thing that could be done to her.
Hustler didn't stop there. In a direct lift from its infamous founder, Larry Flint, the magazine offered 1 million crowns to anyone with juicy scandal to embarrass Czech politicians.
Tam tedy filozofii Hustlera je to provokovat určitým způsobem a myslím si, že tento cíl to spolehlivě naplnilo.
Till now, the Communist Party has been treated like political lepers. But their victory at the polls will force the shaky coalition government here to do business with them, says Vice President Václav Exner.
No, já třeba jsem u moci, vždyť jestliže nějaká strana má v parlamentu více než pětinu svých zástupců, tak je přece u moci.
The Communist Party of today is a shadow of the Communist Party of the past. But many of the faces are the same. So too the ideology and the bid for power.
U nás má politickou moc, ale jestli se ptáte na to, jestli si myslím, že někdy také budeme ve vládě, tak si to samozřejmě myslím.
There is just the barest acknowledgement of the crimes against the Czech people.
Že ano, chyby se staly, dokonce se staly trestné činy s komunistickou legitimací. Je to náš velký problém, je to naše ostuda a hanba. Musíme ji překonat tím, že doufám, se podobných chyb znovu nedopustíme.
But many Czechs, it seems, are nostalgic for the old days. They've returned in their droves to a woman who sang to them in the 70s and who's still singing today. The Czechs' very own Cher, Helena Vondráčková. The 53-year-old has enjoyed a staggering comeback. Bolstered by old and new fans alike, she's enjoying a popularity that surpasses even her days as a communist-era star. Just don't infer she has the communists to thank for her triumphs. She has just successfully sued one Czech journalist for that accusation.
Protože on se i v několika novinách vyjadřoval o tom, že jsem zpěvačka režimu, jak to nazývali. A prostě to já absolutně odmítám. Já jsem nikdy s režimem zapletená nebyla. O politiku jsem se nikdy nestarala. Já jsem
si furt říkala. But Helena Vondráčková was one of those artists who acquiesced to the communist regime in order to keep performing. Her name appeared on an infamous declaration of support for the regime signed by artists and entertainers back in 1977, though she says she doesn't know how it got there.
To jsem se neohradila, protože jako to mi přišlo, to se přiznám, naprosto jako nebezpečný, protože samozřejmě zase by mě určitě po návratu čekaly sankce.
She insists her success is owed to hard work, not built on Communist Party connections. But for many, she represents a link to that past. And for some, it's an uncomfortable sign Czechs have begun to forget. When Helena sued the Czech journalist, the case was defended by none other than politician and lawyer Hanna Marvanova.
Já myslím, že to má hluboké souvislosti i s tím, jak dopadly letošní volby. A to je atmosféra ve společnosti. A že logicky se po těch 12 letech dostavila určitá únova a lidé, mnozí lidé z nostalgií vzpomínají na to, jak to bylo před rokem 89, že věci byly, některé byly jednodušší, že potraviny byly levnější a že vlastně ta třeba zábava, kterou poskytovala tehdejší normalizační televize, byla možná plytká, ale příjemná.
As the country heads into a new era of political instability, the nation's caretakers will have to face the wrath of voters and give them the future promised back in 1989.
Tak odpovědnost mají všichni aktéři, kteří se na té scéně pohybují, takže i já. Nicméně třeba já můžu říct, že mám dostatek vůle, aby se to změnilo, ale tu vůli musí mít větší počet aktérů, politiků.